Scientists say that some sea creatures can recognize their own reflection. So today, we're going to put that to the test.
The plan is to place this mirror deep on the ocean floor and draw in inquisitive and aggressive predators like barracudas, snappers, and big sharks. But this isn't my first time conducting this experiment. Here's what happened with the first mirror prototype I built.
It's a little bit flimsy, but we'll give it a go. Let's go find the first test subject. Right, guys, we're trying the mirror experiment with this big yellow margin moray eel. He can definitely see himself.
But despite having a fearsome reputation, this moray soon scarpered. Did he recognize himself? Inconclusive. The next victim was another eel that soon emerged from his little burrow in the sand to see what was going on. This is a ribbon eel.
So, the ribbon eel hasn't attacked the mirror, so he definitely wins there, but it could just be because he's not very aggressive. So again, I'm not sure if that's a pass or a fail.
But the ribbon eel was also accompanied by a cleaner wrasse, which is particularly interesting as this was one of the species used in the scientific study that fueled this video idea.
He's now a bit preoccupied cleaning a goatfish.
However, shortly afterwards I found another ocean critter that perhaps wins the award for the most intelligent creature that lives on the ocean floor.
Oh my word, I'm not prepared for this.
Fingers crossed this is the perfect subject for this experiment. Oh, he's still there, I can see him.
This little cephalopod is a mimic octopus. And given they're smart enough to mimic over 15 different ocean creatures, surely they're also smart enough to recognize their own reflection, right?
So, he's now facing in the other way. I'm not entirely sure whether that means he's already checked himself out in the mirror or not. He's not seen it yet. So far though, the mimic definitely seems smarter than most creatures. There's still time. Oh, he's now looking at the mirror. Is he gonna do anything? Surely he can see it. Surely. Oh, he's gonna touch it. Maybe not. He's just gonna dig another hole.
But this mimic octopus clearly wasn't in the mood for my games.
No, he's disappearing. Oh dear, oh dear. Well, I guess that's the verdict. The mimic octopus isn't stupid enough to fall for the mirror trick, so maybe he can recognize himself.
But there was one super dangerous ocean creature that patrols these oceans that I was 100% sure would absolutely lose its mind when faced with the mirror. Ladies and gentlemen, I introduce you to the saddleback clownfish.
Whoa! He's gonna break my mirror. The second one seems to be obsessed with its reflection, whereas the bigger one seems to be obsessed with biting me. So, the question as to whether anemone fish can recognize their reflections, it seems to be, well, it depends. The one that's been biting itself for the last 5 minutes definitely cannot, whereas the bigger one seems a little bit more switched on up here than this one here is trying to bite me in the face.
Things were still a little inconclusive though, so in the name of science, we needed more test subjects. However, if I was going to try this with the big ocean predators, I was going to need a mirror that wouldn't fall to pieces in a light breeze.
Well, that's not good. It's just cracked in half. What am I gonna do with this?
We needed something much more robust.
So guys, this is mirror 2.0. I'm a little bit nervous though, because the glue absolutely ruined the first attempt. So this one here is literally the only one we've got left. And it's currently raining very hard. This is gonna be a real challenge.
But although the rain did eventually clear up, we had a much bigger problem.
No, that's super buoyant, man. Oh, this is an absolute nightmare to get down. I didn't put anywhere near enough weight on it. So, it's not really sitting on the ground properly. We might need another plan.
Well, that definitely did not work. This thing was way too buoyant. Probably gonna have to stick some more weight on it, and then we'll try again. Let's give it a test. Oh, much better.
But in typical fashion, I'd fixed one problem but created another. The mirror was now so heavy, I barely had enough lift to drag it down, making it nearly impossible to maneuver.
Oh, now just crack the mirror. Oh well, we carry on.
But eventually, we got it down.
So, we've got camera one just here, camera two is just here, and this cage here is full of bait. I've also put these weights at the back here to stop it from tipping over, but I'm not entirely sure that the big fish won't pull it over, so let's see. I've got to be a bit careful though, because There's all sorts of big stuff swimming around there, and they'll definitely be able to pick up the scent already, so we better be quick.
The purpose of the bait was to try and draw in more predatory fish closer to the mirror. But this wasn't really what I had in mind.
There's a little sand perch attacking himself. Oh dear, poor thing.
So we left the mirror down for about an hour, and I was convinced we'd draw in some of the bigger predators from the deeper water. But given Mother Nature was doing everything in her power to completely ruin this video for me, in typical fashion, the big fish did not come. A few fish teased me as they swam past in the distance, paying the mirror little attention, including this absolutely monstrous yellow margin triggerfish. But other than that, the mirror just got lightly abused by a few butterfly fish. However, there's another spot nearby that I know will give us the action we're after. After all, this is what happened the last time I dropped some bait down there. Right guys, so plan for this morning is gonna be a long one. We are gonna take the mirror down. Still got loads of weight on it. We're taking a little bit off just to make it a little bit lighter to not drown me on the way down. But we're gonna take it down, drop it down like 20, 30 meters maybe. And then we're gonna recycle the cameras for the entire morning. So we're gonna be here for probably 5 or 6 hours. We'll stick one camera down, leave it down for an hour or so, go back in, put some more bait out maybe, swap the camera out, and then just trying to track some of these titans and barracudas and snappers and stuff that are definitely around here.
Barracuda, barracuda!
And boy, did we get some good action. So the following footage is a compilation of all the best bits, building to a scene showing perhaps the biggest fail of this entire experiment, which also happened to be the cause of this massive crack in the mirror. Anyway, like last time, the butterfly fish and bannerfish kicked off the show. Rather than attacking head-on, the longfin bannerfish seemed to use some kind of parallel swimming technique to intimidate its competition, not realising it was its own reflection, but being incredibly confused when it hit the end of the mirror and the familiar-looking bannerfish that was squaring up to it vanished into thin air. I think this is definitely a fail. The black-lit butterfly fish used a similar technique, although he did face his opponent head-on on the odd occasion. He also seemed to get caught in some kind of death loop, swimming over and around the mirror countless times before finally breaking free. But it happened many, many times. Like the bannerfish, the blacklip also failed the mirror test. A few other larger fish swam past, including big trevallies and schools of unicorn fish, but these species didn't seem overly interested in the mirror. Perhaps because they didn't see it, perhaps because they just had somewhere else to be. Although this big puffer definitely saw himself. Now, pufferfish aren't known to be aggressive, so it's difficult to say if this one recognised himself or not, without further investigation. However, as the puffer swam off, something very unexpected swam past. This is an absolutely enormous snaggletooth shark, and this one appears to be pregnant. As an aside, this is perhaps a really interesting scientific observation, as little is known about these sharks in Indonesia, and this might be one of the first good sightings of a pregnant female. Understandably though, this shark probably had much more important things to worry about than checking its reflection. Next time, I think we are going to need a much bigger mirror. Another unexpected species also swam past shortly after, attracted by the fresh bait. It's a little difficult to tell, but I believe this is a Tahitian stingray. Like the sand perch on the previous drop, another small sand-dwelling fish also spent way too much time attacking his reflection. We also had a visit from a small school of tiny striped catfish that seemed to spook when coming into contact with the mirror. Mind you, these fish are scared of absolutely everything, so who knows what caused it. However, this next species definitely didn't share the same concern. This is a monster red snapper, and perhaps wins the award for the meanest looking fish in the ocean, and they are very competitive. This individual swam circles around the mirror for a while, and seemed to be struggling to work out whether to try and open the bait cage, or ward off the second snapper that was mirroring his every move. However, after a few smaller bonks of the mirror, he made the message a little more clear. I always thought red snappers were pretty smart, but I guess they're not that smart. However, about 5 minutes after dropping the first camera, this infamous reef fish came into view. This is a great barracuda, and is easily identified by its big underslung jaw and the black marks on its flanks. Now, bigger barracudas are much more aggressive and inquisitive, and at about a metre long, I was hopeful that this one wouldn't back down from a fight. At first, he seemed a little unsure, squaring up to the mirror but then swimming off. However, eventually he gained enough confidence to approach his rival head on. And, well, here's what happened. Needless to say, this is a fail. Guys, thanks so much for watching. Hit that subscribe button if you're new here, and let me know in the comments what your favourite interaction was. I will definitely be trying this one again soon.
Goodbye.